at home on live stream or catching up later, then the whole welcome too. It's great to see so many of you here. I'm also Father's Day, so maybe there's been other things to be dealt with earlier in the morning. But we're going to think today about Holy Spirit, as we're a few weeks after Pentecost, and we're going to think in particular about how the Holy Spirit helps us. We are going to ask the choir, however, to lead us into worship by singing, I think it's newish to us, a little new to you as well. Singing We Gladly Worship. Now, we're going to have the words up, we're going to have to sing along, but if you want to join in with the refrain, then you can, because it's quite catchy, you might have to. Singing We Gladly Worship. So just stay seated for this one.
Yeah.
Heavenly Father, our life giver, our Redeemer. Thank you for this nice day that we can gather together here in the hall and enjoy each other's company, and most of all, enjoy your presence. Thank you for the Holy Spirit that Jesus promised to his followers, that was poured out at Pentecost so long ago, and the Spirit who travels with us each day of our lives. And especially as we gather as your people in this place, we know that Jesus promised, where two or three are gathered in my name, I will be with them. We know that Jesus is present with us through the Holy Spirit, lifting up our hearts and making us happy and joyful, giving us peace, giving us strength and guidance. All these things come from you, and we thank you for it. We confess that so often we are busier with our own thoughts and our own feelings, and we don't turn to you. We don't ask the Holy Spirit to help us or to guide us. But this is your gift to us and your gift to the church. So we pray that we will feel it, especially this morning, and know that the Spirit travels with us into our lives each day and wherever we go. Let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on the earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debts. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Well, I need some help, and I wonder if somebody would be able to help me move some stuff. I need something strong. I need really strong here. Help me. Right, okay, come forward. I'm just going to put the lights back on so if anyone can see. Play cool. Now, I don't think Ian's really happy where this piano is, so I was wondering if you could move. I'm not sure the choir can hear the piano, so could you move the piano closer towards the choir? Things love for our neighbours as ourselves, to be kind, to be generous, to be patient. And sometimes these things are just too hard for us. We might try, just by our own self-determination, to be good and to live in the way that God wants us, but we'll find time and time again, much like all the people in the Bible, that at a certain point we struggle and we hit a brick wall, or we have a problem that we can't shift, and an attitude in ourselves or in our circumstances that we just cannot deal with, and we can't actually do what God asks us to do. And this is where Jesus promised to send us a helper, a Holy Spirit. So we're going to read a few verses from John chapter 14, where Jesus says this. If you love me, so he says this, Jesus saying this to his friend, heed my commands, and I will ask the Father, that's God the Father, and he will give you another advocate, or a helper, to help you and be with you forever. Spirit of truth. The world cannot accept him because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. So Jesus here is encouraging his friends, because he's going to leave, go to heaven and be with the Father, that he's not going to leave his friends alone, just trying to do their best to live in the way that he's told them. He says, I'll not leave you alone. I'm sending the Holy Spirit, the Helper. And the Holy Spirit, although you can't see the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit will be in you. It's like a superpower that you need to actually live the way God wants us to live. And it's for each one of us individually, as followers of Christ, and it is also for the church, God's people together. And with the Holy Spirit, we can basically do the impossible. I'm not suggesting flying, etc., but we can do what we cannot do without God. So that's a great comfort to us, that we're not alone, we're not orphans. God has not abandoned us, and the Holy Spirit is with us and in us to give us strength to do what God asks us to do. So we're going to sing about that, and that is really a song that's a prayer. Give me oil in my lamp to keep me burning. So the Holy Spirit is like the electricity that powers up our light, and the love in our hearts to keep on loving, and the peace, etc., all the things we need. So let's sing together.
Thank you.
mum can come along with you if that makes a difference. Do you get it? Not sure. Would you like to do that, Chris? Or do it together? Yeah? Right, so I am going to blindfold you, so how do you want to come behind the table? So it's a kind of a taste test. Where you can choose one of these five bowls, and where you're going to be blindfolded and you actually can't see what's in here, and then you could get something really tasty. But
what would like to get something that's really not tasty?
It's possible, yes. I'm going to blindfold for you. Right, so we have different colours, So we have different colours of bowls. We've got a green cover, a pink cover, a purple cover, and like a skin colour, and a yellow. That doesn't really help either, does it? No. Will we see what's in here? I'll tell people and you can't see it, so I'll just tell you what there is. And then we'll change the order. Right. We have some blueberries. Do you like blueberries?
No.
Yeah, I like blueberries. Okay. There are some, I think, like Quavers, cheesy crisps. Would you give that be okay? We have some Jingle Bells. You not sure you want to eat them? You're a bit crunchy with it. Could be a little dangerous to you, be jingling all the way home. we have some sweets, just like, what do you call them? Haribos. And there's cat foods. How about cat foods? how are you going to approach this? Are we just going to go for a random? No, don't tell me. You just need to tell me a colour and then I'll give it to you. You're going to go, okay, that's very brave. I was going to say, you have bought like a phone a friend, and you could ask somebody who you trust to come and guide you. Is there anyone here you can trust that tell you the truth?
Not me.
Maybe nobody loves you enough to tell you what your choices are like. You're just going to say, pink. Okay, so you're brave. Some guidance. Do you think she would help you?
I don't have cat food.
You don't have cat food. I'm sure your mom wouldn't feed you cat food. Does mom want to come and see what that's actually? If it depends, say you have to eat mom. The thing is, I don't think your mom would make you choose cat food. Do you think you're okay to eat mom?
Yeah, I think so.
Same for the other kids to eat. Okay, it was a good choice. So I'm going to try it. Well done. So we'll take the thing off. You want to take that one to your table. We'll leave them all. You want to take that? Or whether we should start going out with someone. and so on and so forth, and the decisions get bigger and bigger. And we all at times need guidance, because sometimes it does feel like we're blindfolded and we can't oversee all of the consequences of the choices we're trying to make. And we know that some of the choices that we might make actually could be not very pleasant, like cat food, or actually harmful for us if we're trying to increase bells. I don't think that would go very well if I had to go to the doctor. So, Jesus, in talking about the Holy Spirit, in the same conversation he had with his friends around the table, also said how the Holy Spirit would not only give them strength to do what was right, but to help them and guide them into all truth. So we've got a few more verses to read, and that's John 16, same conversation, just further on in. Jesus says, "Dear friends, I have much more to say to you, more than you can now bear. But when he, the Spirit of truth, comes, he will guide you into all the truth. He will not speak on his own. He will speak only what he hears, and he will tell you what is yet to come. He will glorify me, because it is from me that he will receive what he will make known to you. All what belongs to the Father is mine. That is why I said, the Spirit will receive from me what he will make known to you." So Jesus is explaining that the Holy Spirit will come to the disciples after Jesus has left them, or left earth, so to speak, and is now with the Father in heaven. They are not left alone, as we said just shortly earlier, but they have the Holy Spirit given to them to help them make decisions in life. The times where we're not sure what we're choosing and what path we should go, the Holy Spirit can help us. Now, I was thinking about this a bit more. That's quite easy to say, that the Holy Spirit guides us, but how does that actually work? You know, how do you know in which way the Holy Spirit guides you? And at times, we're mostly thinking about the big decisions, and of course that's when we most want that kind of guidance, and when we're most likely to turn to God. I don't know if I have the foolproof method for this, but I do know prayer is a really big part of trying to find the will of God. The other thing is, as Karl Barth, the theologian, said, the Holy Spirit is a friend of common sense. So, thinking through things that you might otherwise do is also part of how the Holy Spirit helps us. Prayer, common sense, it could be the guidance and advice from other people, especially other Christians, that they can help you think through what you are needing to choose. And I guess it's important to think about the values that are informing your decision. Ultimately, I don't personally believe God is only just one road set out for you, but God cares on how you walk the road. So, on the basis of what values are you making your choices? And if you go one way, it's not like the map. If you've missed God's way, that's the only way to get back to where God wants you to be. God walks with you through the Spirit, and God is continually wanting to guide you. And just Father's Day today, and for some of you that will be a good day, for others it may be a painful day. But the very best of fathers help guide their children, not by telling them exactly, determining every single step of the way you need to do this, you need to do that. Yes, when you're little, that's how it works. But as you mature, that guidance becomes something that you've ingrained in yourself, and it becomes counsel, and it becomes helping you choose the right way. There isn't just one track for you, but you become the person that your dad has told you to be, the character and the values that are important. So that's how the Holy Spirit guides us to help us grow to spiritual maturity, and that we come to reflect who Jesus was. That's one for the adults to chew over, but God, the Holy Spirit, helps us and guides us to pick the right ways. We're going to sing another hymn, which is about the guidance and Holy Spirit helps us understand the Bible. So we sing Spirit of God and sing as the wind.
Thank you. Yeah.
the conversation. I'm just going to embarrass you by asking to pray out loud on your table. So I just want to take a minute just for a little quiet and think about the things that we've talked about and pray about them for a short while, and then we will, and then I'll pick up the prayer and pray for all of us. So a minute of silence, and then we'll go into. God, we thank you that you hear our prayers. You have heard our conversations with each other. The things we've shared, maybe our personal challenges, the things we need help with to face in our lives, but also the challenges that the church faces, and in particular in our Church of Scotland at this moment in time when all over the land presbyteries are trying to work out new presbytery mission plans with the allocation of ministers and deciding which congregations need to be joined together and how all of this is going to be a positive thing, not just a painful and potentially fractious experience. And each one of us, God, has a role to play in that too. The words we speak about it, the attitudes we have towards it, and how we look at the brothers and sisters in the churches nearby. So we pray for patience, for love, for guidance, and for wisdom. We pray for the ones having to draw up these plans, that they may be guided by the Holy Spirit, and that we will all realize that it's nigh on impossible task. We pray that all of this will not just detract from our mission, and that we will ultimately be in a better position to reach out to our communities and be enthusiastic about church and willing with the Spirit to be creative about how we do church, so that other and more people will be interested in getting to know you and joining your people. We bring all these things to you, and we thank you that Jesus did not leave us as orphans, and that you give us joy, peace, hope, guidance, and strength. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to sing one more song, which we have sung last Sunday and in the afternoon, the junior choir and elder choir. Also sang it, "We are the light in times of darkness."
Thank you.
love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore.